Blackstone Audiobooks presents
Hurlbut's Story of the Bible by Reverend Jesse Lyman Hurlbut. Part First: Stories from the First Five Books in the Bible. Story 1: The Story of a Beautiful Garden. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to chapter 3 verse 24. This great round world on which we live is very old. So old that no one knows when it was made. But long before there was any earth, or sun, or stars, God was living, for God never began to be. He always was. And long, long ago, God spoke, and the earth and the heavens came. But the earth was not beautiful as it is now, with mountains and valleys, rivers and seas, with trees and flowers. It was a great smoking ball, with land and water mingled in one mass, and all the earth was blacker than midnight, for there was no light upon it. No man could have breathed its air, no animals could walk upon it, and no fish could swim in its black oceans. There was no life upon the earth. While all was dark upon the earth, God said, "Let there be light," and then the light began to come upon the world. Part of the time it was light, and part of the time it was dark, just as it is now. And God called the dark time night, and the light time day. And that was the first day upon this earth after a long night. Then at God's word, the dark clouds all around the earth began to break, and the sky came in sight, and the water that was in the clouds began to be separate from the water that was on the earth. And the arch of the sky which was over the earth God called heaven. Thus the night and the morning made a second day. Then God said, "Let the water on the earth come together in one place, and let the dry land rise up." And so it was. The water that had been all over the world came together and formed a great ocean, and the dry land rose up from it. And the great water God called sea, and the dry land he named earth. And God saw that the earth and the sea were both good. Then God said, "Let grass and trees and flowers and fruits grow on the earth." And at once the earth began to be green and bright with grass and flowers and trees bearing fruit. This made the third day upon the earth. Then God said, "Let the sun and moon and stars come into sight from the earth." So the sun began to shine by day, and the moon and the stars began to shine in the night. And this was done on the fourth day. And God said, "Let there be fishes in the sea, and let there be birds to fly in the air." So the fishes, great ones and small, began to swim in the sea, and the birds began to fly in the air over the earth just as they do now, and this was the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the animals come upon the earth, great animals and small ones, those that walk and those that creep and crawl on the earth." And the woods and the fields began to be alive with animals of all kinds. And now the earth began to be more beautiful, with its green fields and bright flowers, and singing birds in the trees, and animals of every kind walking in the forests. But there were no people in the world, no cities nor houses, and no children playing under the trees. The world was all ready for men and women to enjoy it, and so God said, "I will make man to be different from all other animals. He shall stand up, and shall have a soul, and shall be like God. And he shall be the master of the earth and all that is upon it." So God took some of the dust that was on the ground, and out of it he made man. And God breathed into him the breath of life, and man became alive, and stood upon the earth. And so that the man whom God had made might have a home, God planted a beautiful garden on the earth, at a place where four rivers met. Perhaps we might rather call it a park, for it was much larger than any garden that you have ever seen, for it was miles and miles in every direction. In this garden, or park, God planted trees and caused grass to grow and made flowers to bloom. This was called the Garden of Eden, and as in one of the languages of the Bible the word that means garden or park is a word quite like the word paradise, this Garden of Eden has often been called paradise. This garden God gave to the man that he had made, and told him to care for it, and to gather the fruits upon the trees and the plants, and to live upon them. And God gave to the first man the name Adam.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.